The last video, you don't have to learn this for exams, but I still want you to practice it because it's going to help the first three arpeggio videos to memorize them a lot better as well, also to give you a better understanding how music works. Now, first of all, triads, if you're working with Afrikaans, it's called a drie klank, is a three-note chord like a normal A or a normal D or a normal G or a D minor or an E minor, even though E minor's got six strings. There's only three different notes within those six strings. There's an E, there's a B, another E, G, another B, and another E. So six strings, but only three different note names, drie klank. When you go to sevenths, four different note names. We're going to start them all on A, just so that you can hear and compare the differences. First of all, the triads, the three note chords. It's the first, third note of the major scale. One, two, three. We did the major scale at the beginning. First note, third note. Fifth note, one, two, three, four, five. If you're not sure, reflect back to video number one of the arpeggios. This will cover this for you again as well. So it's going to be first, third, fifth notes of the major scale. And then the octave. An octave means eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And you should recognize what I just played if you've learned your first arpeggio in the beginning of the study. So here we got the triad for A major. Okay. When we go to minor, you flatten the third. Now remember, this is might be the second note I'm playing, but it's the third note in the scale. One, two, third note of the scale. We flatten him. So now we get this. Now you can see over here, that's really a lousy stretch. I don't want to stretch like that. So we take this note that I'm tapping with the first finger and we put him there. Same thing. One more time. And you can use the same. Just much more nicer. Don't have to stretch so much. Now listen to the difference between the major and the minor. Classically, they often refer to major as a happy, positive arpeggio sound or chord sound, and minor as a more sadder, darker sound. And you can hear the difference. It's nice and sort of positive, major, happy. Minor, you can hear that it's got a bit of a sadder, darker sound to it. Okay. Now, when we go to quartets, or if you're working with Afrikaans, vierklanke, you add the seventh note to the scale. So we're going to start with A major 7. You go the major scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's my seventh note. And I add that to my major triad. There's my triad. And I'm adding that in. And that's your... Ooh, sorry, wrong note. Okay. That's what happens when you're reading a page, talking, and not looking what your hand's doing. But one more time. And that's your scale you learnt, or your arpeggio you learnt in number one of the arpeggios. That's your A major 7 arpeggio. One more time through. First, third, fifth, seventh notes of the major scale octave. When you dominant seventh it, you flatten the seventh. So you go up the scale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and you flatten it. Now you've got a major triad with a flattened seventh that we call dominant seventh. So dominant seventh is a major triad with a lowered or flattened seventh, and that gives us the dominant seventh chord. Okay, so here the major seventh and the dominant seventh, you compare them. Major seventh, dominant seventh, and that gives us a nice bluesy sound to a certain extent as well. And lastly, we're not going to go into diminished sevenths yet, that's for next year. We're going to look at the minor seventh. It's got that flattened third we spoke about. Remember, we did that. And it's got a flattened seventh. So you've got a flattened third. There's your flattened third. Fifth. Flattened seventh. Octave. And now you can hear the difference. Major seventh. Dominant seventh. Minor seven. And that basically sums up your sevenths we need for grade four. Any questions, drop me a line. I just wanted to get a bit of a theoretical background. It's going to help you, hopefully, as you go through your theory with Miss Markie as well. Okay, but enjoy it.